Thanks for joining us. A young boy who died days after being hit by a snowmobiler on a Minnesota lake. Tonight, friends and family are paying tribute to Alan Geisenkoetter Jr.
Police say a driver of a snowmobile accused of being drunk hit and dragged the 8-year-old on Chisago Lake where he was going ice fishing with his family. Today, a benefit was held on Chisago Lake. Care11's Dylan Woolenhouse reports.
We are going to start drawing for the...
Let it be said that generosity and kindness has no designation of place or purpose and meets in no specific location. But for this act of kindness, it meets on the frozen channel of Chisago Lake.
It's just really neat to be able to come together.
The story of why a few hundred people are here for a silent auction, a raffle, and a fishing tournament.
We've got raffle tickets for $10.
Begins on January 31st when Alan and Ellie Geisenkoetter and their 8-year-old son, Alan Jr., were on the lake setting up their portable fish house.
I mean, it was so fast. He took a couple steps forward to peek at through the back of the truck, and the guy hit him.
Junior was hit by a snowmobile and suffered critical injuries. He died 5 days later.
Got a kid that's a year different from Alan Jr., so, you know, it's really kind of hit close to home.
8-6!
Which brings us to today, a fishing benefit for the family who lost their son.
As much as we can get to the family, the better.
Josh and Lauren Swindle organized the benefit, which is expected to bring in thousands of dollars to help the Geisenkoetters.
Nothing had to be rented or paid for. This is all donations.
The Swindles were so moved by what happened, they organized the event on Facebook, something shared hundreds of times.
We don't know them actually at all.
No.
It was just something where we saw it and we felt kind of obligated to do something.
An act of kindness with a purpose for Alan Jr. and a distinguished effort by strangers willing to help.
But I think so many people care and they just want to help somehow.
On Chisago Lake, Dylan Woolenhouse, Care 11 News.